Hello students, welcome to the class. I am Yogita. Our subject is CNET and Nursing Education for Nurses. And today we are going to learn about types of communication and the techniques used in communication. Now before that, a communication is nothing but sharing ideas, opinion, hopes, perception between two or more people. Now, what are the different levels, types of communication, levels of communication? Here, mainly it is noticed in fourfold communication. Four: interpersonal communication, direct interpersonal communication, mediated interpersonal communication, and mass communication. Now, let us discuss. First, interpersonal communication. It means individual, I am talking about myself. I am having opinion about myself, what I know, what I feel. To understand that, here I need to have a three concept like self-concept, perception and expectation. Self-concept, what I think about myself, what I feel about others to myself, that's important. Perception is interpretation, outlook towards the world. Expectation is you are expecting your future messages, future goals. Now here, this interpersonal communication will help me to develop a harmonious relationship within me and my environment and my world. It will make my life so easy so that I am able to manage myself, my ideas, my thoughts, my feelings. Here, individual can use a vocal conversation, solo, I'm talking to myself, I'm writing a letter, writing a diaries. See, this is all kind of interpersonal communication. I'm making an assessment about myself. I'm thinking, what is my future, what I should do, what decision I must take. If I do that job, how that will be, see, perception. I'm trying to interpret. Okay, these all are called interpersonal communication. A second type is direct interpersonal communication. Now here we are having a face-to-face communication. There will be two people and you are like more than two and you are having a face-to-face communication. That process, that level of communication is known as direct interpersonal communication. In this again we can find certain types like dyadic relations. It means you're having a casual relationship with another person. Like for example, a friendly talk. The kind of relationship, what do you find with your friends? A friendly relationship. Group relations. That means here the face-to-face communication between two or more than two people. For example, no, group studies. See, you wanted to study something, combined studies. See, you are finding a, you are selecting a group of people who share the same ideas, same perception. They are having the same goal and you are studying about that subject. You are making a study, combined study. So, this is called group relation. Then, public relations. Here, a large group will be there and one will be addressing that large group. It's kind of monotonous talk, we can say. For example, now look at in your classroom. A teacher, a lecturer is giving a lecture to the class. 60 will be in the class and teacher is giving a lecture. See, this is called a public relations. A family relations. It is a kind of or a part of your group relation, I can say, because a family is a close united group. You are having a very close relationship. And one more thing is that you are having a long lasting relationship. Correct. See, this will help you to develop an intimate relationship. A very close relationship with the family members. You are trying to maintain and sustain that relationship with love, care, harmony. All we feeling will be there in that relationship. Then, business relations. That means it's a relationship between people for a business purpose. It's a communication between for the level of organization. For the business purpose, you are working with the other people. This is called a business, yeah, systematic organized relationship. Okay, the third one is mediated interpersonal relationship. Here, individual will have a communication, but it is not face-to-face. So that difference you must understand. There is no face-to-face communication. Again, we can find two types here mainly, like dyadic relations. That means here, you are able to speak with others, but there is no face-to-face relationship. Like you may having a conversation over the phone. You are calling and you're talking to them. You're sending a mail. You are writing a letter. See, this is called dyadic relations. Then, group relations. Here, like you are able to study. Maybe you are able to do certain online courses. You are able to talk to a lecturer. It's from a long distance. You are not seeing your teacher. There is no face-to-face relation. But this distance will not be a barrier now. You are able to talk. You can have some teleconference, a video conference. Or like you may have a phone. You're making a call. Or else we are having some meetings. We are having a lot of technological mobile. You can have some certain apps and you can have a meeting. See, this all will help you to develop that relations. Then, this is called mediated. The last one is mass relation, mass communication. Now, mass communication means we are addressing a large group of people. And it is for advertisement purpose, information purpose, health education purpose. You are conveying your information to a large group. For example, radio. See, if you switch on 93.red FM, see, they are communicating to you. They are giving certain informations to you. Look at your TV. Whenever you switch on, there will be lot of movies, entertainment programs, advertisements. They will tell you, if you put little fair and lovely, you are the most beautiful girl. Who knows? It's true or false. You have to try it. See, this is called communication. They are addressing, it's not that they are telling only to me. Even for entire globe, they are conveying the same message. See, this is called a mass communication. So, these are the important 4 levels of communication, important 4 folds of communication: interpersonal communication, direct interpersonal communication, mediated interpersonal communication, and mass communication. So, next we'll move to the techniques of communication. So, the different techniques of a communication: listening, understand your audience, expression, avoid arguments, feedback. See, these important techniques you have to use in your communication. The first is very important technique is listening. You should be an active listener, because we can find many people to talk, buck, non-stop they are talking, but we rarely find people who are really listening to us. So that when you speak, when you communicate, you must be a honest listener. Don't make any false listening. Yes, I'm listening, so that your mind is off. You should not do that. You should be an active listener, and you listen what the opposite person is really communicating or talking to you. Expression. It's very important that your audience is trusting you. So you need to share your genuine perception. Honest expression must be given, because they are trusting you. When they trust, you cannot confuse your audience. You cannot run around the bush and make them confused. That is utter waste of your time, and you're not going to get anything. So always you have a right expression, so that you give a right perception on a content. Understand your audience. Always, before you speak or prepare your speech or communication, you try to understand what's the level of your audience. You see which language to choose. Maybe, for example, you're going to take for class for the first year students, first year BSc nursing, any GNMs. You cannot make a technical terms in your talk there. You cannot see, you may get hypoxia, you may get diarrhea, you may get anorexia. See, they are not able to follow, because they are very new to the course and they don't know these technical words. So you need to explain them. See, you may find lack of sleep, it's insomnia. See, this is the way. You need to understand your audience, then you deliver your speech. Avoid arguments. Arguments will give you nothing. Arguments will give you nothing. It's such a waste of your time. So always, but it's quite natural that we may find a certain people who oppose our views and thoughts. In that case, instead of that making arguments and winning the contest, it's better that you find, was there any fault? Was there anything can be done to improve that conversation, your organized speech? So that action you can take instead of making unnecessary arguments. Very important that taking a criticism in a positive way. Yes, it's not possible, it's emotional and it's hard to face the criticism. But still, you can take an attempt to take all this criticism in a positive way so that you can implement it in your communication way of process so that you will improve yourself. And finally, you take the feedback. This feedback will really make you to understand whether your communication, what speech you delivered, is really understood by your audience or not. Now, I can ask for the feedback. Please leave your comments in your comment box so that I will understand you're able to follow my class or not. Or I need to change the language. I need to use any other simple terms to make this class much more better so that you are able to follow. So please leave your feedback in your comment box. So these are the important techniques of communication. I'm summarizing the techniques. Listening, a very important active listening. Take the criticism in a positive way. Expression, avoid the arguments, understand your audience and feedback. So this is all about your levels of communication and techniques of communication. I hope you understood. Take care of yourself and I say thank you. Bye-bye now so that I'll meet in the next class with a new concept. Thank you all.